This is Warriors Unfiltered, conversations with the team. I'm Lawrence Scott. Today we're joined by Warriors broadcaster Jim Barnett as the team heads to Memphis for Game 3.
What did you see in Game 2 that will be corrected in Game 3?
I didn't even recognize this team in Game 2. In any aspect of the game, it was the poorest shooting I've seen in a long time. You know, when you have Klay Thompson and Steph Curry, two great shooters, go 3 of 17 from three-point range. It wasn't as much discouraging as just incredibly unbelievable. But I have to give credit to Memphis because they did a pretty good job running them off the three-point line. And Mike Conley came in and surprised everybody. I thought it was a very courageous performance by Mike Conley, and he had one heck of a basketball game. And they changed the series right now.
When you look at what the Warriors did on the boards, it was still an exemplary game from Andrew Bogut in that regard, and also Draymond Green. Everyone makes such a big deal about the bigs on Memphis, but these guys pretty much are neutralizing the Memphis bigs.
Yeah, the bigs are going to get their numbers, but their numbers haven't really hurt the Warriors per se. You know, they're not getting a lot of shots. If you look at the number of shots that Gasol has gotten, I mean, they're limiting the shots there. But this team, when they go to Memphis, is going to play very, very differently. And Steph Curry loves to play on the road. You know, the last time down there, he had 38. Thompson had 28. So, as bad as they were in Game 2, as badly as they played, with 2 minutes to go in the first half, it was a two-point game. And even later on, it was a 7, 8, 9-point game. But every time they made a run, Memphis would come back and hit a clutch shot, hit a two, whether it be Courtney Lee or Mark Gasol. Someone would get a two. A three-pointer by Conley really hurt them at one point. Steph Curry missed a three that would have brought it down to six with about four plus to go. And I would have bet my house that he was going to make that shot. So as badly as they played, they were still in the game all the time because Memphis has a more difficult time scoring than the Warriors. But the Warriors have to get back to their game, get some stops, and they need to get out and run. When you have 16 assists and 20 turnovers, that's just an aberration for the Golden State Warriors.
You talk about getting out and running. I mean, you've got a team that you're facing where their identity is grit and grind, as they say. How do you grind down their grind?
Well, you've got to play with them physically. There's no question about that. But in Game 2, obviously, Memphis set the pace, and they made the Warriors play that pace. And I think a lot of that, not only the missed shots, but just a lot of it was were the turnovers. And, you know, you're trying to squeeze a ball in between two people, and there's no play there at all. And they just weren't themselves. And so I think they had a terrific practice the day before they left for Memphis on Thursday, and I think that's going to help. You know what? You have to have a little adversity to measure everything by and to get some gains. And I think that is going to turn out to be a good thing for the Warriors, a little wake-up call for them, and they've got to be sharper. And, you know, the two players, really good veteran players, run a two-on-one, they end up with a travel rather than a basket. That just should not happen, and it will not happen.
Thank you to JB for joining us. And he will have pre- and post-game coverage on Comcast Sportsnet Bay Area for Game 3 on Saturday. And our coverage will pick up from Memphis right here on Warriors TV.